Welcome to Gudauri, Georgia, the most incredible ski resort you've never heard about.
The country of Georgia is lodged between Turkey and Russia, east of the Black Sea, and in a region called the Caucasus. In the Greater Caucasus range on the northern border, many peaks are towering over 5,000 meters, including Mount Elbrus, the highest in Europe, and Mount Kazbek, north of Gudauri Ski Resort.
The highest point of the resort is at an altitude of almost 3,300 meters. 40 kilometers to the north is the Russian border, and circling all around the mountain is the Georgian military road.
That route has been used since antiquity to cross the mountains and is still today the main link between the Georgian capital of Tbilisi and Russia, at least when it's not closed due to heavy snowfall.
The whole resort is located completely above the tree line, giving the skiers much more possibilities to go down than just the regular slopes.
However, as most of the skiers who come here are beginning their ski career, the vast majority of them prefer to stick to the official pistes. Tourists mainly arrive from Russia, the Middle East, the UK, and the US. Some of them will see snow for the first time, others are attracted by the extremely low prices.
Understandably, accommodation and restaurants are more expensive here than in the rest of Georgia, but they are still a lot lower than what you would pay for in any other ski resorts in Europe or North America. Here, Gabriel and I paid less than $200 each for an annual pass. It's less than $150 American.
Most of the visitors do not bring their own equipment and instead will rent it at one of the many affordable rental shops. Although usually good, the snow conditions might vary a lot from one week to the other. Without much vegetation on the slopes, you sometimes have to look out for pointy rocks if the thermometer doesn't cooperate.
But when it snows, many areas turn into easy and accessible off-piste.
Those zones can be reached directly from various chairlifts, or with a short hike or skinning session. Plus, as off-piste is not that popular here, it is possible to ski in fresh powder, even a few days after the last snowfall.
It snowed here 2 days ago, and pretty nice.
Snowmobile tours are also offered, but sadly, the gentle and snowy slopes also attract a few less respectful snowmobilers who create deep and hard tracks on some of the best backcountry sections.
Snowmobiles are so popular here because in fact Gudauri is more like a winter resort than a ski one.
There are many options here to party. And also to try new activities. Every day, one after the other, paragliders soar from the top of the mountain and fill the sky with colorful sails and GoPro lovers. Over the skiers and the gondolas, they fly down the hill, brush against the apartment buildings, and land between the waiting instructors and the many restaurants.
Because of course, being in Georgia, you have to try the fantastic food.
There are the big dumplings called kinkali and different types of kachapuri, including the fabulous Imeruli, which is basically a boatload of cheese.
And for dessert, try the chirchkela, a candy made of walnuts coated in grape must in the shape of a candle.
The jagged peaks and snow-capped mountains really give a magical look to the scenery. But even the chairlifts offer different spectacles and experiences.
It's a bit weird to be in a ski lift without skis and with a grocery bag. With the delicious Georgian food, a magnificent winter scenery, a plethora of accommodation, always inexpensive, and often fabulous ski, Gudauri is a great place.
If you like it a lot, there are still many possibilities to invest.
But my suggestion would be to spend 1 week here and plan another one or four to go visit all the other destinations of fascinating Georgia.